Robin, have you got a second?
I do. What's up?
Well, I just came from a board meeting, and you have been cleared of any involvement with Lisa Niles' murder. So the board would like to reinstate you as chief of staff, effective immediately. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. But I can't accept. I really do appreciate the vote of confidence, but I've come to realize that I'm not the right candidate for chief of staff, if I ever was.
Well, this is a 180.
Circumstances change, priorities become clearer.
Robin, if this is about any kind of resentment because the board asked you to step down, please believe me, they never ever questioned your ability to do the job.
This isn't about any hurt feelings on my part. I've just had a chance to reassess.
Well, I really want to make it clear that their concern was protecting the hospital with an ongoing murder investigation.
I know. I didn't take it personally.
Okay. Well, that's a relief.
Being asked to step down, it was like a gift. You know, I was finally given the chance to realize that I've been so wrapped up in my job to the detriment of my family. I mean, I was like a ghost in my child's life.
Well, I can understand that. I mean, when Alan was chief of staff, and even when I was, our kids were grown. They were out of the house. But Emma's so young. I mean, you got so many years with her. They're precious. You don't want to miss them.
Right. Emma deserves a mother who is present in her life. But I am sorry about leaving the hospital hanging.
Oh. Well, don't be. We'll muddle through somehow. And anyway, I'm good until then.
Well, they should offer you the position permanently. I mean, you're really the only one that's qualified around here.
Well, thank you very much. We'll see.
Have you seen Jason lately?
Actually, I went over to his penthouse last night to see how he was doing after Thanksgiving.
What happened in Thanksgiving?
Oh, it's about everything. Seemingly out of nowhere, he just lost it. He turned over a table. He stormed out of the house.
Okay, when you say out of nowhere, is it possible that your family was having an argument?
Well, I mean, Tracy was her usual nasty self, but it wasn't anything that should cause him to go berserk.
Berserk?
No, actually, well, it reminded me of the way he was after his first accident and after that surgery when he was just wild and out of control.
Jason needs to come in for a post-surgical follow-up. Obviously, something is not right.
The one time Jason did come in for an appointment, I ended up distracting him.
Why is that your fault?
Well, Elizabeth was in a crisis. She was crying for Jake, and I sent Jason in to calm her down.
Well, that doesn't surprise me. Jason taking care of everyone but himself.
Yeah, well, he can't do it this time.
When I saw him at the PCPD, he said he'd been having minor headaches, but, you know, nothing short of passing out is no big deal to him. And then there was this one point where he was distracted, almost like he couldn't hear me talking to him. It could be nothing physical, but I still think a CT scan is in order.
Well, you keep working on him. I mean, between you and Sam, you have more influence on him than I do. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.